asked me to give a lecture here. I think I gave a couple of lectures, so this was my first time lecturing in a big room with here in this room. And this is mostly for Igor. So this was the proceedings from that in 1990. And let's see, this is mostly for Igor because the number is 9108. It's paper in the archive. Yeah, if you want to see the first papers on the archive, these are the first ones. Also on this trip, I met Sergio Cicati for the first time, and we've been collaborating. Guess I don't need this anymore. No, thank you. So these were some things that I wanted to finish up with last time and didn't quite get to. So just to write, so I'll be discussing today six-dimensional theories, starting with 1-0 supersymmetry. And so 1-0 supersymmetry has 8 supercharges. This is the same number of supercharges as 5D minimal supersymmetry, or it's 4D n equals 2, or 3D n equals 4. And the supersymmetry algebra looks like this. So these are the supercharges. This is a Lorentz 4, so it's in the 4 of the Lorentz group. And this is a SU2R symmetry doublet. And we need 2 of them just in order to get the algebra to work right, because because this thing is symmetric and we get the vector by making something that's anti-symmetric. If we anti-symmetrize 2 spinners, we can get a vector. And so we need this extra SU2 quantum number to get something to work right. Here I put in parentheses that there are also central terms that can be added for BPS strings. These theories have strings that can be BPS saturated. And so there's a central term here that gets supported on strings, but I'll leave it off for the moment. And in terms of this group theory, these are the Lorentz quantum numbers. It's in the 4 of the Lorentz group. I put the R symmetry quantum number up here. So this 1 here means there's 1 box in the SU2 Dynkin diagram, so it's a doublet. So this is 4 in a doublet of SU2R. And so the stress tensor multiplet, for instance, has 40 bosonic and 40 fermionic degrees of freedom. One check of all of these multiplets is that they should have the same number of bosonic and fermionic fields. And so, for instance, the bottom of this field is a Lorentz scalar. Its dimension is 4. It's a R symmetry singlet. Then, when you act with the supercharge, you get some fermionic operators. When you act with the supercharge again, you get the SU2R currents. So this notation means this is a Lorentz vector, and this means it's in the adjoint of the SU2R symmetry. So that's the SU2R currents. These are some brain currents. Then when you act with another supercharge, you get the currents whose integral gets the supercharges. So these have a spinner index and a vector index. And it's a doublet under the R symmetry, so that's what this one is. And then when you have one more supercharge, you get the stress tensor. And so this we always have in any conformal field theory. And the source for these, it's often convenient to turn on sources for operators, just like when you take an introductory field theory, you turn on these sources for the operators, and then you can write down effective action. And so if we want to write down sources for these operators, it would be the background supergravity multiplet. So if you're interested in supergravity, the metric couples to this. There's some SU2R gauge field that can couple to this, etc. So that's the gravity multiplet. And here I'm not actually going to be discussing supergravity as a dynamical theory, but just thinking about it as like backgrounds for these operators. Okay, then another multiplet that we could talk about is the flavor current multiplet. So flavor current multiplet has 8 bosonic and 8 fermionic operators. And what they look like is the bottom operator is a Lorentz scalar, and it's in the adjoint of the R symmetry. And these operators operators are sometimes called the moment map operators. They're also there if you look in four-dimensional n equals 2 or three-dimensional n equals 4, you have these same operators. And then when you act with the supercharges, you get these fermionic operators, and then at the top of the multiplet, these are the currents. And so it's in the... It has a Lorentz vector index, and it's a R-symmetry singlet. And in terms of this counting, 8 bosonic plus 8 fermionic, I should say that this is has 3 operators. This is like 3 bosonic operators, because it's in the adjoint of the R-symmetry. And this thing has 5 indices, but only has 6 indices, rather, but only counts as 5 operators because of the conservation law. So this thing counts as 5 bosonic operators. So those are the 8 bosonic operators, and then these are the 8 fermionic operators. And this is also similar to what we would have if we went down in dimension. So if we go down in dimension, we can go to like 5D n equals 1, or to 4D n equals 2, or to 3D n equals 4. The difference is that when we dimensionally reduce, some of these Lorentz indices just become scalar indices. So like in 5D, instead of just having a Lorentz vector here, we have a 5D vector plus a scalar. And in 4D, we have a 4D vector plus 2 scalars. And 3D, we would have a 3D scalar, a 3D vector plus 3 scalars. And scalar operators, when we go down to lower dimensions, give us possible mass terms that we can add to the theory. Here, because there are no scalars, there's no associated mass term with these dimensions. So maybe I'll just say here that there's no... We have a real is opposite chirality to the fermion in the hypermultiplet. And that's how they couple to each other. They couple when a charged hypermultiplet gets a mass. Its superpartners are that the Gay-Geno here can pair up, like if we have a Higgs-type mechanism, this Gay-Geno here can pair up with the fermion here with a term like psi alpha lambda bar alpha bar delta alpha alpha bar, something like that, where this is the scalar component of the hypermultiplet. So any questions about any of that so far? Okay, so one other multiplet to mention is the 1-0 Hatzer multiplet. And we have, in this work that I did with Cordova and Dimitrescu, we studied these different multiplets and had these names for them based on their BPS shortening conditions. So this one's name is C2. So this is refers to a shortening condition. The 2 is the place where there's a null ascendant. So the important thing here is that the bottom component is a real scalar. And its dimension is 2, which is the free field dimension in 6 dimensions. Because if we write d phi squared, that has dimension 6, if phi has dimension 2. And it's a R symmetry singlet. And then the supercharge takes this to 1, 0, 0. It's a symmetry doublet. And then at the top of the multiplet is 2, 0, 0, 0, 3. And this is a self-dual 2-4. If I write it this way, it looks like it has 2 symmetrized spinner indices. So 2 symmetrized spinner indices, but we can relate that to 2 anti-symmetrized. So these indices run from 1 to 4, these indices run from 1 to 6. We can relate that to anti-symmetrized vector indices. And self-dual means that if we write this 2 form as x, then D is a 3 form, which satisfies this kind of a self-duality condition. So this is a chiral 2-4. Or chiral boson, let's call it. Okay, and this field as a free field, the hypermultiplet, is a free superconformal field theory operator. It's in the classification of operators of the superconformal group. And the tensor multiplet is also a free operator of a superconformal field theory. We can have a superconformal field theory that aren't free with these operators, but if we just look at this as a free field, it's a conformal field theory. And then we could also try to build up interacting theories from these components. But the reason why I mentioned that these are conformal field theories is because the vector multiplet is not a conformal field theory operator. not equals to 4. If you look at a gauge field, like a free Maxwell field, it's conformally invariant in 4 dimensions, but it's not conformally invariant in any other dimension. Just because a free Maxwell field always wants to have dimension 1, and its FBD always wants to have dimension 2. And so then if we write down 1 over g squared, f mu nu, this thing should have dimension d.